Hi everyone, my name is Dmitry. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Electronics Manufacturing Technologies. In this video, I talk about soldering pastes, about different types of soldering pastes and soldering fluxes inside them. In this video, you will learn 10 very important factors about soldering pastes. I'll try to cover useful information as possible in one video. Let's get started. First topic, what solder alloys exist and which one to choose? Solder pastes can be leaded and lead-free, low temperature, high temperature, and also different exotic alloys. Most of the time, the choice of solder paste depends from customer process specification. The most common alloys, the standard leaded and lead-free types. When you select a solder paste for your PCB, you should ask yourself, first question, what alloy is used on balls in microchip for your PCB? This is a very critical question. If the BJ balls lead-free, like a SAC305, then your solder paste should also be lead-free. I know mixed soldering is possible using two different soldering alloys, but the best soldering joint quality is achieved when the BJ balls and the soldering paste use the same reflow profile. The reason is simple, melting points difference. A gap 20-30 degrees of Celsius can be critical. When using a leaded paste under lead-free profile with a peak of 250 degrees of Celsius or 480 degrees of Fahrenheit, a leaded alloy will melt early and may cause a boiling and splattering. Just in case you need to know, the melting temperature in reflow oven for lead solder paste is a maximum of 210 degrees of Celsius or 410 degrees of Fahrenheit, and for lead-free soldering paste, 250 degrees of Celsius or 480 degrees of Fahrenheit. The second question, what is immersion coating of your PCB? It's again about different alloys, but the immersion layer is usually thin and won't significantly affect the reflow process. Second topic, soldering flux inside the soldering paste. Flux in solder paste is classified according to international standards. I will leave a link here and in description on this video to helpful video on soldering flux classification. There are 18 different types of soldering flux that can be used in electronics manufacturing. Your choice depends on the process speed and the condition of your PCB and components. In most cases, ROL0 soldering fluxes is used for standard conveyor soldering. And here another key question, do you clean your PCB boards after soldering or not? This directly affects the choice of flux, whether it's in solder paste, syringe or liquid form. Active fluxes, like this, require mandatory cleaning. No clean fluxes, like this, can stay on the board. In my opinion, cleaning a PCB is always the best practice, except in the case of very low-cost electronics. Third topic, choosing soldering paste based on the process. The soldering paste, its flux and powder type must all match the process specification provided by the customer. For example, the customer may require a leaded or lead-free process, but you, as the manufacturer, may still verify this. Check the components, check the surface immersion finishing coating, make sure their requirements match the actual parts and technology. If you follow their instructions blindly, it may ruin the job and lead to disagreement. Fourth topic, soldering paste types and powder size. Solder paste contains spherical powder particles, small metal balls. Each paste type has a specific range of particle diameters. You must choose the type based on the component size and the aperture geometry in the stencil. The table shows you which soldering paste types is approximately suitable for your components. The analysis applies to the smallest components on your PCB. The higher the type of number, the smaller the particles. The lower the type of number, the larger the particles. It's simple. Smaller components equal smaller particles equal higher paste types. For 0201, you should use at least type 5. Why is this important? Larger particles can get stuck in the stencil apertures. There are two ways to determine which type of soldering paste you need. First method, the 5 balls rule. Print solder paste through the smallest aperture and inspect solder paste print in PCB under a microscope. Count how many powder balls fit across the pad. If you see 5 or more balls, that's perfect, that's good. If it's only 3 or 4 balls, you need a higher paste type. For example, you use soldering paste type 3, you see 4 balls across the smallest part, that's too few. The soldering paste may get stuck in the stencil or leave a weak print. The second method, calculation based on aperture size. Ask your designer for a smallest aperture width in the stencil, then divide by average ball size. In the table, you can find different soldering paste type and how many balls across the width of the pad. Both methods can work, but more balls equals better paste release. Now I ask you to pause this video. Please like and subscribe. You can ask questions in the comments or write something to promote this video. Thank you so much. And right now, fifth topic, storage condition for soldering paste. Always store your soldering paste in refrigerator, not in the freezer. Before using, the soldering paste must be mixed. If you use industrial mixer, it's great, it also warms the soldering paste. If not, take the paste out of the refrigerator 4 hours in advance, let it warm up, then open and mix it manually. Right now, sixth topic, conditions for quality stencil printing. Use a high quality stencil. Choose the correct paste type. Mix solder paste properly. When applying soldering paste, room temperature should be 20 degrees of the Celsius or 68 degrees of Fahrenheit, humidity 50%. Use flat undamaged squeezy blades. Never use expired soldering paste. I came to seventh topic. What's written on soldering paste jars? Good marking. Alloy is clearly shown. Both sides shown. For example, 25 or 45 micrometers. Flux type written like ROL0. Paste type marked. T3, T4, T5, expired date shown. And bad marking. No alloy listed, no particle size, no paste type, no flux class, no expiration date, words like no clean may mean anything or nothing. Exact soldering flux classification is very important, especially if boards will be washed after soldering. Same for labels like lead-free or plumbum-free. There are many lead-free alloys and it's critical to know which one is used. If you need water-soluble paste, it must say it clearly with flux class. You will not understand what activity the flux in paste has. You need the exact class. For example, ORL0, ORM1, ORH1. All these classes are water washable fluxes, but with different activity. Poor cleaning of active fluxes can cause oxidation or corrosion. And right now, topic 8. Stencil quality. Never save money on stencil quality. The edges and corners of the aperture are very important for smooth paste release. Polished or electro-polished stencils are strongly recommended, especially for 0201 components and high-type solder paste. Use IPC 7585 standard stencil design guidelines for control and design stencils. And right now, topic 9. Common mistakes when choosing soldering paste. Many workers pick paste by habit, for example, using type 3 for everything. This can cause problems, bridging, poor prints, weak solder joints. Some blames the soldering paste printer, but the real problem is the powder type. And right now, topic 10, solder paste viscosity types. Type H, high viscosity thick paste, good for hot rooms or when the paste must hold its shape longer. Often use it for manual printing or with dispensers. Type M, medium viscosity, the most common type for stencil printing, balanced flow and shape retention. Type L, low viscosity, flows easily, use it for fine pitch components, small apertures or cool controlled environments. Viscosity is important, but it's a secondary parameter. It affects how long the paste can stay open on the PCB board before reflow. If you print solder paste at the end of your shift and leave the board for later, store them in the fridge. If your room is hot and the temperature cannot be controlled, choose a paste with higher viscosity. Low viscosity soldering paste may spread too fast, it can lose shape before reflow. High viscosity soldering paste will hold its shape longer, it's better for warm room temperature. My tip, before starting a new PCB batch, do a few test prints. Check under the microscope, are they dry zones, bubbles and bad release. Different batches of the same solder paste may behave differently. What matters when choosing soldering paste? Choose the right solder alloy. Choose the correct soldering flux type or follow your customer specification, but always verify it. Choose the right powder size, soldering paste type. Choose the correct viscosity. If this video was helpful, like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have questions, write the comments. That really helps this kind of technical content reach more people. In description on this video you can find links to my Instagram, my Telegram group, please subscribe, also to my website with soldering fluxes like this and for consultation. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.